Okay, hello, welcome back to Land Rover Toolbox videos. Today we're going to do a little bit of road testing in the 110. Firstly, on the road.
Hello there. Yeah, look, they smiled and waved.
And then a little bit of low box off-road, right, just to check the operation of it. Obviously, some of you are probably more expert off-road than I am. However, we're looking at the roadworthiness of a vehicle in this instance. So basically, first of all, you'll notice that I have my steering wheel on the cock. This is because we never adjusted it when we fitted the steering box back on. This will do later. There's a 22mm socket on the nut here. It's quite easy to do. Okay, now road testing, basically we're looking at steering performance, brake performance, and general overall vehicle performance. In the back of the vehicle, we have an engine in the load space, which simulates a full load on the vehicle, and it's only sensible to do this with weight on it. Right, so obviously we want to be keeping an eye on the gauges. I've also got the sat nav here to give me an accurate speed reading. The last time I took this out, it was doing 66 miles an hour while the speedo was reading 70, which is a bit ridiculous, to be honest with you. There's a little bit of difference there.
Now it's not behaving itself at all. As you can see, the cable is probably not very serviceable.
I've got to watch out for speed cameras as well today. Not that we'll go too fast, but however, we're going to push this vehicle through a range of tests. First one basically is to find a piece of road which doesn't have a camber on it. All right, it's possibly a secluded area where there's no traffic. Obviously, your vehicle has to be legal to take it on the road. However, what we want to do is just to make sure the brakes pull up evenly first. This is one of the first checks you will do when you do a road check. You don't want to be out on the road and find that you're pulled right the way across and could cause an accident. So this is the first thing we check for. Right then, so first of all, what we're going to do is check the brakes are pulling up evenly. Right, so I'm on fairly even ground. Oh, you can hear that gearbox pull up a little bit. Let's get her straight. Hands off the wheel and see how she pulls. That pulled a little bit actually, because that's, I hit a couple of bumps. Try it again. Yeah, no, she's all right. She's pulling up evenly, so that's not a problem.
If your brakes fail this test, then the first thing to do is to go back and rectify them. Do not carry on with the road test until these brakes are sorted. The technical name for the vehicle pulling to one side is a brake imbalance. Anything over 30% is very dangerous. You will notice this on your vehicle straight away if it's present. If you're happy with your brakes pulling up evenly, next thing to do is to progressively check the performance by driving at down to a junction, for instance, and then stopping. If you're happy with that, move a bit faster. Basically, we'll move through the range of 30 to 60 to 70 miles an hour and coming to a stop. You can usually feel if your brakes are okay. If you're unhappy with your brake performance, then they will need to be rectified. If you need a more verifiable test, then a garage should be able to do a tapely meter test to tell you how efficient your brakes are working.
Perfect braking, yeah, that's all right.
Next thing we want to do is to see how the steering is handling with the brakes, how the vehicle pulls off, what sort of transmission noises there are, how your clutch pedal operates. Generally, with a Land Rover, it's hydraulic, so the clutch as the wear proceeds on the clutch, your pedal will come up, so there'll be less bite, as it were.
In other words, that means that you will have a biting point higher up the pedal as the clutch wears.
Whoa. Okay, so I'm pulling it up to speed, about 50 miles an hour. Okay, if anything or any wheel wobble is going to happen, it's going to happen around now. All right. Can't feel anything. So you can see the steering wheel, I'm holding this, I'm on the main road, I'm holding this okay. She's not doing that. If she was doing that, we'd have a problem and I'd have to slow back down again. We want to see how the steering handles at certain speeds with your vehicle. So for instance, if we're pulling up at 60 to 70 miles an hour, you don't want to be feeling vibration in the front. you'll feel it through the steering wheel and it'll become uncomfortable to that point, basically, where you're going to want to pull back. Right, now that needs rectification, obviously.
I'll push you up to 60 miles an hour. I've got my lights on. I'm coming up to a wooded area as well. Okay, so she's fine. This is what we want to look for with regards to our steering.
Okay, suspension. Right, when you're driving along a road, especially UK roads, a lot of them now have potholes in them and they will tell you straight away what the suspension's like. Weight in the back will also slightly exaggerate what's going on.
Okay, so I'm in fourth. She pulls lovely actually. With weight on, Land Rovers tend to pull a lot better.
Okay, with the engine specifically, we'll be looking out for rattles and noises. We want to make sure that the engine is at running temperature, first of all. And this way, we know that all the components are expanded correctly. So we'll drive along the road and we'll be feeling what sort of performance it has with a weight on it. Then we can pull it up a hill and see if we lose power. Obviously, if you select too high a gear with weight on, you know you're going to fail. Whereas you approach the hill, like here, it's going to be somewhere half sensible where you're going to be fifth or fourth gear. You want to make sure that you have enough acceleration or enough power underneath the accelerator to make sure that you can achieve it to the hot top of the hill.
One thing, if you find yourself quite a wide area, you can then check your steering lock to lock. Okay. And the other way. Lock to lock. She does it right, she pulls, no problem. Does it self-centre though? The Land Rovers are not very good for self-centering. I think you'll find that you'll have to help it a little bit on its way. Last little bit. They're not like cars.
Okay, so checking the diff lock, basically we can see that the light comes on by moving the lever or the handle. The thing is, with this vehicle and the conditions of the road today, we're not going to be able to lose traction anywhere and try the diff lock out. So what we'll do in another video is show you how to check your diff lock with your axles jacked up.
Okay, low selection on the gearbox, low selector here. Basically, you go from high stationary with your clutch depressed, push it into low. I find that if you lift the clutch up just slightly, she'll drop in and she won't pop out when you drive off. Okay, so basically, low gear is like that, and that's what it's specifically designed to do. There's no reason for high lock, a diff lock on this sort of terrain, and there's no reason to go incredibly slow. So what I'll do is drop it in at third, get myself some progress. Nice little puddle here. Shall I push for it? Oops. That's a bit hard on the suspension there. Okay, anyway. Driving, testing it, what I'm looking for is, I'll show you. If there's any severe noises from the transfer box area. Now we're in a lower gear. There shouldn't be. Running all right. So basically, right, there we go. Low reverse. Nice little addition to the to any gearbox. Obviously, it's a pity you can't change while you're driving. Otherwise, you'd have a big selection of gears. However, never mind. Okay, so if you see up ahead, this is probably the best feature of Kingsley. If you're ever up this way, is the church there. This is actually a public highway. It's a green lane, public access. There's also a Land Rover garage at the end of it if you need to, church farm. So basically, I'm going for a little drive now. This is the best part of test driving. In a Land Rover test driving, you get this facility to do off-roading. Away from the traffic. And look, there's absolutely nobody about. I should think the wife here, sat nav, is gonna tell me to turn around at some point and go back home.
However, we'll have a little joint first.